Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. I am Akshat Bahety and in this video, I have a single goal. By the end of this video, you should be an expert on scraping anything across the web. And for that, we are going to do two things. First, we are going to learn everything about crawling, extraction and scraping. And we are going to use an extremely popular tool called Firecrawl, which is super famous on making sure that you can scrape without worrying about anything. And the reason that I'm going to teach you this is for one simple reason. Anything that starts in AI starts with data, and you need data and you need to go and find different kind of data for different kind of clients and for different reasons from the web. So we're going to take a real example on how you can actually utilize your scraping skills to create something new with AI. And let's get started with this. Okay, so very simply, let's think about this. Like, you are creating blogs for a small and medium businesses. And I'm going to take an example here of a plumbing business in US. So I'm just going to pick up a city, plumbing business in Ohio. I was searching about this. You see, there are so many plumbing businesses available here. And you also have, like, you know, someone rated at number one Google search is pretty crazy. Let's open this link and you can see this company actually has a blog, right? Again, they have a blog which has been running. They have some articles here, but they don't have a lot of them. They probably have, like, you know, are not creating them or something like that again, but they have some articles here. Addition to that, this is not the only company that is listed there. If you come back to the Google search, there are so many other companies who are 110% doing more of this stuff. So you can click on Waterworks and they, like, you know, right now are ranking pretty low onto the web. So you can use scraping, look at other companies' blogs and create blogs for them, help them rank better, which is simply search engine optimization, but it still works. And that's why, I'm telling you, learning how to scrape data from other websites and utilizing that for your own use case is the most critical skill. So let's get started. So the easiest way to set up Firecrawl is just sign up using GitHub. I'm already signed in, and once you are signed in, you will go to dashboard. And in dashboard, you see all those things. And then here you have the option to start utilize your API key. I'm not going to show the API key. Just copy this API key. Come back to n8n. And here again, just like, you know, I'm just going to, like, you know, pick up a Firecrawl node so I can show you from scratch. Just pick this node up and come here. And as you see, I already have an API. I'm going to click on create new credential and just paste my Firecrawl node here. That's it. I don't have to do anything else. It's as simple as that. So just to repeat, you copy this, click on this copy button, come back here, paste it all here and just save it. And you will have everything connected. It's the same API key. So I'm not going to generate anyone new, and we're going to close this. You can also manage your API keys from the left hand side to do more stuff. You can obviously, like, you know, generate more API keys if you want, and it's pretty cool. I will also have a referral link in the description so you can get a bonus on the credits that you get from here. Perfect. So I'm just going to remove this. Okay, in the simplest format possible. I have very simply a competitor list here. I've already taken an example of the plumbing company. I have a simple AR base created here where I have this base, which technically has the competitor name, the homepage URL, and the blog page URL. Now, once I input this data, you can just simply create these tables. You can come here and I search that record. So I'm just searching that record, and if the record is not processed till now, it shows up here. The second thing that I'm doing, if you see, I don't want to go ahead and scrape every particular blog. I have the URL where all of their blogs are hosted, and you can just see there, you can click on blog page, and that's mostly how every company's URL is. Like, you know, it's just plumbing.one/blog. Okay, now once I have that, I want to ensure that I get all of their blogs also, right? I want to get all of their URLs. I want to get all the data in a single place. So for that, I'm going to use this Firecrawl function here, which is to get blog URLs. And just to show you, we insert in Firecrawl, right? And you get this Firecrawl node here, and we are going to select from here, map a website and get URLs. You see this, map a website and get URLs. You have like 6 to 7 different options, but right now we just want to, like, you know, again, get all the URLs that are listed for that particular blog. So I'm going to copy the URL here, right? And just for, like, you know, purposes, I'm going to select this. You can see you can include a sitemap, which is just every website has a sitemap that is given to Google to help us index better. You can include it, you can only select that, or you can completely skip it. I technically say let it be included. You have a limit on how many URLs you want to scrape. Now, you can have 5,000, like, massive websites, something like, you know, a HubSpot or a Zapier will have like 5,000 some URLs, but this is a small website. I can just keep this limit to 20 to get all the stuff. And then you have a timeout till what level you want it to keep scraping. So I can click on execute, right? And right now, okay, it's already started scraping here. So you will see here, it's already scraped here and it's going to scrape again. I should not have connected two nodes together, but again, you scrape this and you get all of these URLs here. You can see you have the URL, you have the title, you have the description. And it's exactly that simple. You can input a single URL. This is just an example that I'm showing you to input a URL. But this is where you can utilize this operation to get all the URLs that are there. And you can do this for other companies also. So let's say, like, you know, one of the companies that has a really popular blog system is rate.com, right? It's a mortgage company in US. And they write a lot of blogs to rank higher on Google and, like, you know, really help people also, like, you know, with informational stuff. And you can offer the services to other businesses also. So you see, they have, like, you know, a ton of blogs, and they have blogs by topic. So you can utilize this, you can copy their, like, you know, link, and also, like, you know, just paste that and get more list of all the URLs here. So if I just change this and connect this to this, and I will just, like, you know, go ahead and delete this, connect this to the trigger just for testing purposes. And click on execute, and it will now go ahead and get all the URLs. The best reason that I use Firecrawl is because it's super fast and also helps do things in a very, very easy way. You just input the URL and you get all of these things. And plus, it also allows you to change this, increase this, or something like that. I have the limit to 20. I can increase that limit and we can do more. But it's pretty, pretty cool. Right now, it pulled out some URLs. We can obviously increase the limit and change a couple of settings to get more data. Okay, with that, this is your map URLs information, where you can get all the different kind of URLs from a blog page and from other pages, right? The next step that you technically want to do is just, like, you know, this is a split out function. I am just splitting all these links. So let's just, like, you know, run this. So let's run this in a second. It will take a second, and then you have this, and then I have a split out because I get around 10 items, 10 URLs of their blogs. So I split that, and then I'm just going ahead and updating them in my Airtable. So I just click this. It's simply updating in my Airtable base. So in this particular table here, in this SEO optimization table, it's going to go ahead and update. So I'm going to just delete these records, right, and delete all selected records. And then technically I can run this, and then it will just go ahead and update all of this data back into this Airtable. So you see it has automatically added all the data here. That's pretty good. Now we have the list, but we still don't have the content from these places. We don't have the actual content of the blog. And because we don't have the content, we still need to do one more step, which is, so you use the map option, which is to get all the site URLs. Then you use the second option, and that Firecrawl provides, it's scrape a URL and get its content, which is the most common option you will use. You will use this to scrape any URL. So you want to go ahead and search across a website, search any kind of data where you just want to get the data of the website, you're going to use this option, which is to scrape a URL. So we're going to select that. And for this, I'm just going to run this, right? It has the option here. It's going to just scrape one right now, just for, like, you know, testing purposes. I'm just going to click on this, and now it will go ahead and scrape that particular URL. So this is the URL we have got, like, you know, conventional versus tankless water. I'm just going to copy and open this. So you get this whole thing, like, you know, which has, like, you know, as we saw, XYZ, a very simple blog, and probably people are searching for them, and, like, you know, this is something that they offer as a service, and you get the whole content here. As you can see, this is a massive content that has come. All the URLs have come in a markdown format. And you can directly, you're going to use all of this content and upload back into our base. So what we can do is connect with Airtable and simply update a record. And then in this, I just want to technically select which column to map on. I want it to map on very simply the Airtable blog URLs, because that is the easiest one. And I'm going to add the blog URL here, so it will update the exactly the same blog URL that we are doing. So not this one, we are just going to select the one that is common limit, update this because we are scraping it one by one. And then in blog text is where I want to technically, like, you know, change nothing. Just do a quick refresh. I don't want this. I just want in the text, all the content that is scraped in the markdown format should be placed here. And then I can run this, and you will see in a second, we have got all the content here. So you can click on this and you see we have the whole content here. Now again, this does not need to be super nice looking, because the point is we are just going to copy and paste this and dump it into an LLM to create any kind of blogs. I have a whole video on how to utilize this content to create a blog, but this is how you can easily scrape all the content, and that is just perfect. You can do this for over and over for every one of these. So if I just, like, you know, again, technically remove this limit and want to run this whole thing and let it run, it will go ahead and scrape every one of these URLs and actually upload the text here, which I can directly use in any place I want. And that is just crazy. You just have to do it once and you have this data. You can do this as an activity for any business out there and create so much rich content for them, which will cost you nothing. And it's a repeatable system that you can go ahead and implement. You just need to find, like, you know, just DM these people. I'm going to send you 10 blogs for your company easily. This is the easiest way to get started on your AI journey, because don't overcomplicate it. Learn this simple stuff and go ahead and create things. But now you must be thinking, that's fine. Like, you know, all of that is still okay. You can scrape content, you can get content. But there is still a problem when you have to get content in a specific format. Because right now, like, you know, again, you might get content, like, you know, again, in system, you might have all of these details, but you might want to also get data in a more structured format. And that's where I want to introduce you to this particular flow here, which is to extract content. And let me just, like, you know, bring out the trigger here and we can move this. So let's just focus on this part, okay? So right now, one thing that, you know, you have to think about is, let's say you want structured format, like a tabular format of data. You don't want to go through, like, you know, and scrape data in this format. Then you utilize the extract content option here. Here, extracting data is something that is going to be super important, right? And it happens in two steps. Is first step, you input a URL here, right? And the second step is to define a schema. So you come back to Firecrawl, you're going to click on extract. Okay, and this is, like, you know, again, one of their, you're going to click on extract and you're going to click on playground from here. And once you're on playground, you're going to describe something here. So you're going to say, like, you know, I'm going to take the example of, like, you know, a lot of people want to find jobs, right? A lot of people are trying to find jobs right now in the market. So I'm going to take this Y Combinator jobs URL and come back to the playground. And here in this playground, I'm going to say extract from this the jobs in the following format. Okay, and in this format, you're going to technically just simply say, you're going to simply say company name, location, salary details, and job designation. Right, and now you see, I'm not actually running the command, I'm clicking on generate parameters. It's now going to generate parameters of what kind of response I want. And this is really cool because we can use this directly. So you come here and you see this schema, this is what we want. You can see the JSON part, I've already copied and pasted this into my n8n, but you can just copy and paste it. This schema is super important to get the kind of format of data you want. So let's say you're trying to extract data in any format, from a financial company, from another company, you can use this to get the exact structure of data. Once you have that exact structure of data that I have already pasted here, you just select this option of extracting data, and then I have already input a prompt here, right? Again, like, you know, and then you can also add an additional prompt, which is just going to be, like, you know, with company name, title, salary, and location. And it will go ahead and utilize the schema. You can also do a couple of other things. You want to search it, you want to allow it to web search or anything else, which is not needed at all. And just click on execute a step. And now, as you see, we get this ID. Extract is not instant. And the reason behind that is it technically goes through the web page, takes all that data and then converts it into a schema. So for that, you get this ID because it's already running an operation. And then after that, I have this extract status option. So I was doing this by default, but in this extract status option, you just input this ID that we have already got and you can click on execute step. And you can see the status is processing. So technically it takes roughly 1 to 3 minutes depending on the scope of data. I believe, like, you know, this is going to take roughly a minute or so, just because it's going to extract all of this data and format it in our particular requirement. So we're going to wait for a second. So we have done that extract content. Let's check again. And, like, you know, again, you can just click on this execute step. And you can see, like, you know, again, it has given us a formatted data. It has got both the things. It has also got the option as a text. And then from there, it has got all the data in a formatted process. So you have all this information in a very structured format. And now I can take all of this data and you can see, like, you know, again, we have fields to split out. And I'm going to pick up this headings thing here, drop this here. It's going to split out all this data properly in the right format. And then we can come to this, our append row sheet, which is already here. And I was trying to, like, you know, again, it's, I've changed, I did not write company name exactly, I wrote company. And then you can just, like, you know, title, and then you can have, like, you know, again, salary and everything else. And now I have this particular sheet, this blank sheet here, and I can just click on execute a step and it will go ahead and update all this data in a second, in a single place. And that is just crazy. You can run this automation in different formats. I'm doing this for jobs because that is one thing that people have been asking to, how do you automate your job process? This is one of the things that you can use to actually automate your job process and find the right opportunities. Just imagine that instead of this trigger, I have a schedule trigger here, okay? And I have a schedule trigger here, which technically just runs every day and brings out the new job opportunities that are on the job page of any other company here, right here in your particular sheet, and it keeps running automatically. You don't need to do anything. And that's exactly how you can use automations in your personal utilization also, but also you learned how to extract content, get the status, and then append this in the row. And that brings me to a simple part. You know what extraction is now. You know how to get content in a very structured format. You know what is crawling, which is technically just like, you know, going in and seeing different URLs. And you also now know what is scraping, which is technically pretty simple, like, you know, again, getting the content as it is. These are technically the trifecta of understanding how scraping works. There is a lot of nuance in, like, you know, more complex scrapes if you're trying to, like, you know, beat captures and everything else. And Firecrawl already does an amazing job at it. But if you are watching till here, you are already better than 99% of the people who will actually ever learn about scraping. So here is one last step that you can do with this. Go ahead and take this template. It's available in the description below. Go ahead and download this. Practice it yourself. Utilize it with your own Airtable and Google Sheets and see how you can scrape different data, and you will have a ball. This is the perfect tool to get started. And if you want to learn more, go ahead and sign up for our school community where the link is. If you like the video till here, please hit that subscribe button. It helps me out a lot. Does not cost you anything. It takes a second. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next one.